And if we look in root there, we can go ahead and cat out our root.txt, paste that into TryHackMe, and there we go.
Hi friends, welcome back to the channel. How do I get the lights out of the reflection of my glasses? My name's Ash, I'm a cybersecurity enthusiast, and on this video, we're gonna be going over gaming server, another TryHackMe room. For my notes on this room and all others, links or timestamps, please see the description below. Otherwise, let's go. All right, we're on TryHackMe. We've got gaming server here, an easy boot to root box for beginners. Awesome. So let's go ahead and select start machine. We've got task one. Can you gain access to this gaming server built by amateurs with no experience of web development and take advantage of the deployment system? Looking for a user flag and a root flag like usual. So we'll see if we can ping the IP. We're definitely on the TryHackMe network. Okay, there we go. Just had to give it a few more seconds. So let's start off with a Rust scan. Didn't find any ports. Since the ping took a little bit, I think maybe the box just needs a little bit longer. A few seconds later, and yeah, we can get a successful scan. So we've got SSH and HTTP. So we'll go look at it through the browser. Dragon. I guess that this is the game that they were talking about. Quickly looking at our source, we've got freewebsitetemplates.com. And down the bottom, we've got John. Please add some actual content to this site. Lauren Ibsam is horrible to look at. So there's a first clue of a possible user that we might want to use. So like usual, we're going to be running further scans. Make sure you run dash dash. I don't know what I'm doing. Okay, there we go. While that's running, let's go ahead and get a Forex Buster scan using our web content medium list. See if there's any hidden directories we can find. I see uploads. Okay, we've got a few interesting things. A dictionary list. And if we open this up, looks like we've just got a list of possible passwords. So we've been given a user and we've been given a list of possible passwords. So let's try and Hydra in. Oh, before we go any further, there's also a secret key. Okay, so we've been given a private key also. So what this is telling us is this is going to crack this private key to get the passcode. So we'll use this private key to SSH in. All right, let's go make a copy of everything. So I'm gonna go ahead and make a key file. I'm gonna paste that in. Then let's go get this dictionary list and we can go ahead and just download that. Okay, so with our key and our dict list, we need to make a hash to crack from this key. So we can go ahead and use SSH to John, which we can input the key that we've made and output the hash that it will produce, and we can call it whatever we want. I've just called it hash. And if we go ahead and look at the hash, that's going to actually show the hash version, which we can go ahead and crack. So I'm pretty sure we need to do more specifying, but essentially we want to pass our hash through John the Ripper with the dictionary list. I'm pretty sure we need to go word list equals dict list. Oh, that's right. I've done this before. So I need to go dash dash show the hash. Yes, there it is. Because I've already done it, that's what I had to do, but yours should just show you straight away. Okay, so now we've got the username and now we have the passcode to use the private key. So our user is John. We're logging in with this. We're gonna use an identity file, which is gonna be this key. It's gonna say yes, and that's gonna say what's the password for the file. And I forgot my permissions again. I'm gonna redo this. Change mod 600. That is the permissions we need. Okay, let's try this again. What's the passphrase? Not the user password, but the passphrase that we just cracked. Did I type it in right? Is it working? It's not doing anything. I broke it. Okay. No, it was just thinking. It was just taking its sweet time. All right. Awesome. We've got our user.txt straight up. All right. We'll go paste that in to TryHackMe. Awesome. So now it's just over to escalating our privileges. So a first good thing to do is sudo dash L. We don't know John's password. Maybe it's a weak reuse of a password. Yeah, not so much. So let's just have a look around the box and see what we can find. Looking at our Etsy password, we do have a Pollinate user, SSHD. I'm not sure what they are, but we sort of look like the only normal user. John. Is there anyone that actually has a like a bash shell? Looks like it's just John and then root. So we're not looking for another user that we can go into. Yeah, so I don't really know what I'm looking for. So when in doubt, linpeas. So I've got linpeas already
downloaded. So I'm going to run a Python server here, and then I should just be able to go wget my IP of my machine, which is in the top right corner. And we should just be able to specify linpeas.sh, and we can just go and download that. Great. Now we have linpeas. Just go change mod plus execute, and we'll just go ahead and run that. So our Python server. So the first thing that is standing out is in our users and groups. The user that we are logged in as is a part of this LXD group. So what we can do is go ahead and look up our version of Ubuntu on the system and look up this LXD escalation. ExploitDB is a good first search result. We also have Hacktrix, which is great. So sometimes these things just take trial and error, but I have it on good authority that this is going to give us what we're after. So let's go ahead and follow this exploit. Step one, download the build Alpine. So I'm going to go ahead and grab this URL and do it on my machine. So we'll grab that. So we've got our build Alpine. Step two, we are to build Alpine. So we're going to go bash build Alpine as root, sudo bash build Alpine on our local attacking machine. Okay, once we've run that, this is what we want to put on the target system. So I'm going to control shift C that name. I'm going to set up another Python server. Then like we did earlier, we'll go ahead and grab it via wget. So we can go ahead and copy this. Let's go ahead and create an exploit sh and paste in the contents. Control X. Yes. So now we have our exploit. Let's go ahead and change the executableness of our exploit so we can actually use it. Great. So that's allowed us to execute. Oh, here it is. Execute our exploit. If we go back to our exploit here, we've got the dash F flag to pass through the file name, which is what we currently have, the Alpine file. So we run the exploit sh file. We go dash the Alpine through it. And yeah, I mean, it works like magic. We're escalated our privileges. Let's go over to our root. So I can't see anything. We've got this ash history. That looks like it's just our history. So where is this root? Right. So since we're actually mounted in, we need to go mount root. Then we can actually see the file system. And if we look in root there, we can go ahead and cat out our root.txt, paste that into try hack me. And there we go. That was gaming server. So thank you so much for watching until the end. Got to admit, it was a little bit more trickier than just an easy, straightforward room. Up on the screen, you're going to see the video to Year of the Rabbit, another good boot to root try hack me walkthrough. So definitely check that out. I'll see you in the next one. Thanks, guys.